Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Shelter in Place book by Nora Roberts. It has some of the rhythm of Blue Smoke, a little similar of Northern Light, some of the art influence of The Collector. It was an up-to-date problem that is on a lot of people's minds when they go into a movie or a mall, if this could happen. Sometimes there were happy tears and sometimes there were sad tears, but no matter what, there is always a happy ending. She delves deep into her characters with multiple details, binds them together in the story, and then wraps them up in a bow when complete. But Nora builds on this story, taking a mass shooting in a heavily populated mall theater, and creates characters who try to formulate lives from that devastation. Nora Roberts explores how survivors and their loved ones of a mass shooting continue to live their lives after the news stopped covering the story. She deals with mass murder in a tactful, non-graphic manner with characters you can easily identify with and root for. It grips you from the beginning and weaves the lives of a large group of people together who were all a part of that day in some way. It also serves to remind that once the general public forget the event, the survivors and the families of dead, injured, and traumatized live with the grief, fear, anger, and terror forever. Another great novel from Nora, Terror Happens in a Mall, and changes the lives of three best friends forever along with others. Dealing with tragedy, losing your friends and family, and dealing with all the grief that surrounds that made some people stronger and gave them direction in their lives despite what they went through. She takes the situation and crafts a story reflecting the pain, denial, growth, and victory that can be the outcome of surviving horror. The rest of the story is about surviving when others didn't, and a backstory on why the shootings happened. It also has the energy and grittiness of Roberts in death stories and the timeliness of showing America's struggle with seemingly unending gun violence. This book grabs your attention from the beginning, and as it progressed, it made you wonder what is going to happen next or who is on the list to die next. As always, the Nora Roberts formula provides engaging characters and evil protagonists that pulls them all together in a book that you don't want to put down. She took a socially relevant issue and gave a deeper understanding of the continued trauma the victims experience as they go through life. If you haven't figured it out yet, Nora Roberts is a storyteller who has no literary equal, and Shelter in Place is well worth the purchase. Think carefully before reading this if 9/11 thoughts brings you fear, or you have lost a loved one in a large shooting. Have read all of her works, love Nora Roberts' writing. Shelter in Place was no exception, some parts predictable, but that comes from knowing her work. Yet in the midst of the pain, beauty arises and carries the reader along all senses on alert, stunning emotional work. It is a very timely and well-written account of a mass shooting in a mall and theater by three teenage boys. The main story, however, is not about the shooting nor the shooters, but the survivors and how this event impacted their lives. You would be able to read it without knowing the author and be able to know almost immediately who wrote it. You see these shooting and TV news and think how awful, but what you don't realize is the lasting effects on the people involved, but also everyone around them. As always, Nora Roberts weaves a story that keeps you reading when you should turn out the light and get some sleep. She creates characters who seem to live and breathe and puts them in situations that have you laughing one minute, teary-eyed the next, holding your breath the next. How those left behind deal, or in some cases don't deal, with the death and destruction those with evil in their hearts have perpetrated on their spirits. The journey after the massacre as they deal with moving on and living their life, becoming adults, finding their careers, falling in love, while dealing with more terror was amazing. It was a great thing to do on the hot southern summer afternoons when being outside wasn't on the list for people in our age bracket. Everything a reader could want is there: tragic event, real people, evil people, misled characters, and plenty of character development and romance. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.